If you've ever been able to smell your own taint, I just don't know what to tell you.
So, how y'all doing out there? My name is Mr. Brooks.
And I'm Don motherfucking Grimm. And yeah, this is In With The News. You are In With The News because we're in with the news and you're in with us over here. So yeah, that's how that goes. And that whole taint thing, by the way, I wasn't talking about like if, you know, you've been to the gym for the last 3 hours and you happen to go home, take your clothes off to jump in the shower and you happen to smell some things coming from yourself. You work up a sweat. That's kind of normal. But I mean, if you're like fully clothed and, you know, and you're walking and the wind is even blowing away, like any scent you might have blowing it away, but you still smell your own fucking taint at that point. That's,
I don't know why, but I just automatically assumed you meant like up close, smell it.
Well, I mean, I can understand why you would have thought that, like, yeah, let me,
because I'm over there thinking, man, y'all some fucking flexible motherfucker.
No, I'm like, well, I'm talking about motherfuckers that just they fully clothed, just standing still or walking, whatever, and just happen to be like, is that my taint? God, I hope nobody else smells that.
Is that you? Is that you? Is that your taint or my taint?
Right. Like, you ever be driving and you smell like some fucking burning oil or some shit and like, oh fuck, I hope that's not my car. You know, same thing, you know, you same thing. Like the car it's coming from actually goes away and you're like, oh God, thanks.
Thank God that fucking old lady's gonna be on the side of the road, not me.
Right.
Dodge that fucking retarded bullet.
Well, it's just like the whole taint thing. If you smell it, ooh. I fucking hope that's him, not me.
Man, I'm going to go down this aisle and hope I don't smell it over there. All right. So listen, man, I wanted to say something before we move on into some segments here shortly. Okay. These fucking isms, man, we've been hearing about them my whole life. Obviously, racism, sexism, and all that shit. But, right? I mean, you know, I'm not crazy. There's so many of them.
Yeah.
But a long time ago, a little while back, I heard of ageism. And I'm like, who in the fuck is hating on old people? Old people picking on young people too much? That I could see. I mean, I understand these sensitive-ass fucking young people today might not, they can't take it. You know, my grandfather was, like, brutal about the clothes I wore. And, like, just, you know, awful stuff.
Well, so, I have heard of the ageism thing being thrown around, you know, but I haven't heard it recently. And when I did hear it, it wasn't very often. It wasn't made to be a big deal. But as far as I understood, it was like toward the elderly, you know, like,
yeah. But I mean, that's how I saw it too. But I was just assuming that the only time anybody would be pussy enough to use that kind of accusation would be a young person. I can't imagine. I mean, now if it's an old folks home and somebody's beating on the old people, I don't think that they're mad at them because they're old. They're just beating on the weak. They would probably do it if that's the same people. Some end up going to a daycare and beating up little kids, and some of them end up going to the old folks home and beating up old people.
It's like kennel. Almost
the same type of thing. Yeah.
Same kind of people that take a cattle prod walking down the fucking, you know, the middle aisle of a kennel looking for this, you know, pathetic looking little dog. Like, oh, you look. Look how fucked up you look. You know,
canineism.
Yeah.
But
same kind of person though.
So I wanted to bring up one that I never heard of, and maybe I'm ignorant, but I just saw it, maybe it was today or yesterday. And it said it was on some profile somewhere, and it was like, stop aldism. And
what?
I was like,
wait, whatism?
Autism. And I'm like, did this motherfucker misspell autism? I'm trying to be a smart ass, you know what I'm saying? Like, stupid motherfucker. Yeah, you're right. Stop ignorant motherfuckers that can't spell. Whatever. No. Like, before I, you know, because I wasn't going to say anything anyway, but before I made that assumption in my own mind, let me go look that up. And it's a fucking thing. And autism, AUD, everything else the same, identical word, but with a D, is for fucking deaf people.
Okay, so like the word audio. Okay, that makes sense. Yeah.
Autism.
Yeah.
For deaf people that are being fucking just tortured and tormented by the mass amount of people that can hear shit, and they're just constantly going. She can't hear me, so she thinks I'm funny. But you know what I'm saying? Like, who the fuck is making? I've never. Who is that evil? You know what I'm saying? I get why people make fun of them. You know. Okay.
Careful now. Careful now.
I get why people make fun of some things, but who the fuck is sitting around bashing deaf people and so often that they had to make a fucking movement? Like, I mean, stop. I mean, it was big letters, man. Stop autism. And you know they probably got some fucking ribbon. I don't know what color is even left. They're like, we have cornflower is our color because that's the only goddamn one left.
Well, okay, look, here's my concern with any time I hear any of these is that, you know, it's always, there's always some group somewhere that pushes it to an extreme. So what's the only way to combat autism? I mean, do you literally, are they going to be like, I'm just not going to talk anymore because it's unfair to them that I can say things that they can't hear, and, you know, and you know what? Shame on you for talking. Shame on you for playing music. I mean, at least with talking, they can read our lips if they've learned how to do so. But with music, they can't read the lips on the stereo. They can't read the lips on, you know.
I'm sorry.
You're not allowed to play music anymore.
That's what I'm saying, man. You can never just be normal. And I hate to use normal because motherfuckers be like, oh, no, he didn't. Did you hear what he had said? We are abnormal human beings. And that's not what I'm saying. But, like, whenever a doctor – so you're blaming on the doctor when he says your baby looks perfectly healthy and normal. That means there's nothing, quote unquote, wrong. That means he's got all his toes. If he don't, then they say, well, he's defect. He has birth defects, which means he's defective. I don't know what right. I'm going into now. I'm just saying that nobody is hating on deaf people like that, and I don't know what's next.
It's just ridiculous.
One for bald? There's got to be one for bald, man. Like when people go bald and they get picked on, there's got to be a fucking bully group. Comment below.
There's probably a bully group for every damn thing you can think of. You know, people who still eat rice instead of quinoa. You know, there's any damn thing. I don't know.
We're going to move on, but let's make sure we stop the fucking autism and autism. It's like, something like old country motherfucker. My son's got autism. Yup. You hear me? You know. Autism. Don't even you fucking belittling a real fucking problem, which is autism. You know that shit is a fucking big problem. So fuck you, goddamn deaf ass kids, or you know. All right, just kidding. I love deaf people.
But fuck the idea of you know there being people that are hating on them though. Because yeah, come
nobody,
on,
nobody hates y'all. We all love you, man. And we feel bad because we listen to fucking movies on fucking surround sound. It's awesome. And I'm not really tripping because you can't hear me say these things. So I'm not even hurting their feelings anyway.
They're reading
it. And if somebody right goes to them and goes, hey, man, you know what he said? I'm going to be like, why'd you go over there and fucking tell her that? You know what I'm saying? She didn't have to know. So you're the fucking problem. I'm just being real. Anyway, we're running behind again because I'm going to fucking yipping and yapping.
Yeah, that's all I do.
According to Don Grimm, it's playing right now.
What's up, everybody? It's your boy Don Grimm, and yeah, it's shit talking time. Check it out. I'm like really irritated with this shit going on in our schools. I understand that once you're of a certain age and you can you know think for yourself, make you know decisions that can affect your life permanently. You know, once you're old enough, mature enough. Go ahead and do that. That's all fine and fucking dandy. But, you know, to to put children in a situation where you're making them part of things that they have no business being part of. Like, you know, for example, why the hell is this LGBTQXPQRZ thing being pushed on our kids? I understand, like, it's good for kids to just know how the world works and whatnot, but, I mean, damn, to tell, you know, a little boy, oh, you know what, if you decide you want to be a little girl, that's just fine. Or to tell little girls, you know, the opposite, I want to be a little boy, that's just fine. That's bullshit. That's bullshit. These are children. They're not supposed to be even concerned or even, you know, aware of what the differences in their genders are until a certain point. And then all you're trying to do is teach them and inform them so they have a foundation for making future decisions based on that knowledge. You don't push shit on kids. Let them be kids. Don't push politics on kids. I mean, you know what? This irritates me so badly. The government sets these laws saying, you know, kids can't drink. You gotta wait until you're 21. Can't smoke marijuana. You know, in states that it's legal, it's, you know, usually like 21. Can't vote until you're 18. You know, can't drive until you're 18. Can't even buy cigarettes until you're 21 anymore. But you know what? We're gonna push all this other crap on these kids that are too young to, you know, have the maturity to handle them. I mean, critical race theory, really? You know, there's teachers in elementary schools that are forcing white kids to apologize and give a reason why they are apologizing for having white skin. It's like, what the fuck? I mean, you know what? You're not going to get an apology out of me for shit. And if I find out somebody's trying to make my kids feel that way, you're going to see me. You're going to deal with me. And I feel that should be the mentality of every damn parent out there. You know, if you turn this around and you replaced white with black in this scenario, there would be absolutely no end to the mass hysteria that would ensue. There would be no end. The world would cease to turn. All hell would break loose. But because it's white folks, though, but because it's white folks, you know, the evil blue-eyed devils, then it's okay because we're evil. You know, we're just, you know, by the virtue of our white skin alone, we're just evil. So critical race theory is, you know, okay, right? Fuck that. Hell no. The fact that they put that in schools is literally to try to get their hooks into these kids as early as they can for their future army of complete fucking mindless brainwashed libtards. That's exactly what the fuck it is. That's all that it is. You know, and it's indoctrination. I mean, look at our colleges. Look at our colleges. I mean, for fuck's sake, you know, they're full of socialists and communists and, you know, Marxists and what does that tell you? What does that show you? I mean, it's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. Keep that shit out of our schools. Keep that shit away from our kids. That's all I gotta say.
Mm-hmm. You know, I just cannot stand the idea that just think about how many schools there are. Okay, just think about your city alone, how many schools there are. Then think about the county, then the state, and so on. How many schools, how many children pack those schools? Now, that huge-ass number of kids, just think about how, you know, the teachers are pushing all this shit on all those. You're literally creating an army of libtards. I can't stand the fact that, you know, that's what we have to look forward to in our future, you know, and it's sickening. You know, everybody out there, you know, that lives in an area where this is being done, which is pretty fucking widespread now, talk to your kids, really. Tell them, you know, that shit ain't right. Go to the school when they have school board meetings. Walk up in there and tell them you got something to fucking share with them, or, you know, set them straight. Tell them, you know, gather up as many other parents that you know, agree with you. Go all up in there and say your fucking piece. Set these fucking people straight. Light a fire under their fucking asses to, you know, to see how fucking retarded they are. Just take action.
I don't know where in the fuck that shit happens at, but it don't happen where the hell I'm at, man. I don't know. I'm not saying it's not happening. Don't nobody take that way. Where I'm at, the shit just don't. We ain't doing shit like that. I ain't seen no shit like that. And if I do, you best believe you'll probably all know about it. You know what I'm saying? You already would have known. But first, you know, it's not even the white, it's not even the gay stuff. It's just like, just don't tell kids nothing. If you're not their parents, don't tell them a goddamn thing. Just tell them the fucking math. If you're a math teacher, talk about fucking math. If you're social studies, talk about the fake ass history that's in the book so that when they grow up, I can teach them the real fucking history the best I can. None of the other shit is necessary, man. Nobody gives a motherfuck who you voted for. Nobody gives a fuck what you fucking think is hot or sexy or fucking none of that shit. Keep all that shit out of there. You know what I'm saying? It's bad enough that we got kids shooting up the school because of other kids. Like, now they're fucking not good enough. You're going to tell fucking... Let me tell you something. Everybody likes to fucking assume, and it's mostly true, that, you know, if a motherfucker shoots up some shit, chances are you can put money on it was a white motherfucker. So now you're telling all these kids they got to fucking feel even worse. They're already, you know, apparently, according to the fucking left, they're apt to snap. You know what I'm saying? So that's what you're doing to them, telling them that they got to go around and apologize for what they are. And I know a lot of people, you know, might say, well, they had to do it back then. You know, it was that's how it was for them. I'm like, yeah, I know. And it was bullshit. But we're past that. If we're not, then... I'm going to tell you, man, you're not. It's not a fucking smart move, because I'm not fucking doing it. Kiss my motherfucking ass. I ain't sorry for a goddamn thing. I ain't did shit. I'm good to everybody, bitch. Anyway.
You know, this whole critical race theory thing is basically condoning bullying as well. And anytime that you hear about kids shooting up schools, there's always some sort of backstory about, you know, bullying and torment and whatnot and getting fed up. And I mean, if you really believe in, you know, trying to prevent these things, then you'll try a lot harder to push the idea of equality, equal treatment, and all that stuff. You know, you can't just go from we were a racist country, you know, to an extreme started and did a huge amount of healing from that, but now all of a sudden somebody's feeling booty tickled, so we're going to flip it around and bring it to the other fucking total extreme of now the other, you know, instead of pushing for equality, you know, some sort of middle ground, you're like, you know what, you know, shit hasn't fucking been healed completely, so what we're going to do is we're going to flip the fucking script on everybody and we're going to start pushing racism again, just in the other direction. That doesn't work. All you're going to do is piss people off. All you're going to do is, you know, you're going to end up creating racists. You're people that had not a single fucking racist bone in their body are going to end up hating everybody else because you're pushing them to that fucking point. When they start feeling all the hate toward them because of what you're teaching,
well, see,
they're going to become hateful.
They started seeing the divide, you know, kind of heal back. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Every time it does, they have to do something. You know, there's a new cop murder or some bullshit happens. And George Floyd ripped it all the way back down to the fucking bone, really. And it was unnecessary that it would end up like that. But the truth is like now this can create hatred coming from both sides again. You know, for them, it's like it looks good for them because it keeps us so busy with that, man. So people really need to.
And speaking of the divide caused by George Floyd, you know, one of the biggest problems with that is that you have one side that believes 100% that it was this cop's knee on his neck that killed him. You got another side that says, oh, well, the autopsy said he had so much fucking fentanyl in his system along with other things that he died from an overdose. And you got some people saying, well, yeah, of course that's true. Look at this video from this angle that came out in the fucking trial where it shows that his knee is barely even touching him, you know. But then you got other people in the middle that are saying, you know what, I really don't know. I wasn't there. I didn't see it firsthand, so I can't say either way. But then the one side is going to say, no, fuck that. It was flat out fucking murder, period, no matter what anybody else says. And if anybody questions it or anybody looks and says, well, I'm not sure, you're a racist, period. You're a fucking racist.
Well, or if you're like me, this shit never happened in the first place. It's an illusion.
You know what's fucked up? I saw some of those videos showing that side of things as well. And I'm like, God, that's, you know, you have no idea. You have no idea, you know, anymore what the fuck is true. That could have been, you know, just a fabricated incident just to push an agenda. We've seen that happen in the past.
Yes. All right. So now that we're heavy on George Floyd topic, let me completely change everything with a video.
Oh, please do.
Okay. Here we go. enjoy. Everyone enjoy this.
What's up, y'all? It's Mr. Brooks. I wanted to talk today a little bit about gay people. Gay people, trust me, as a straight person, we don't give a shit. It's like gay is the new vegan. It seems like you just have to tell everybody or some shit. You know, I think that things get misconstrued as if straight people somehow hate gay people or something, and that's not the case. I don't know anybody that gives a shit about whether you're gay or not. I really don't. I haven't heard anybody say anything derogatory about gay people in like fucking 20 years. No one cares. The problem I think that a lot of people that are straight have with it is that it gets constantly shoved in our fucking face. It's unrealistic what they're doing, like in Hollywood. You can't have a show. There's hardly any new shows come out anymore where they don't have a gay character or a same-sex couple or, for that matter, interracial couples. If you have a scene in the classroom, the people in the class have to have like an Arabic Muslim person, you have to have an Asian person, you have to have a Hispanic person, you have to have at least two or three black people. If you don't have any white people in the classroom, that's fine. You know, the teacher has to be some sort of, you know, special person. And like, there's always got to be, everybody's got to be included. And it's so ridiculous because it's not realistic. The percentage of gays is not enough at this point, at least, to have one in every single room you walk in. It's the damn Hollywood people and the shows are trying to appease gay people or appease these people or that person. It's ridiculous. There's not that many gay people. And it's fine if there are. I don't give a fuck. Nobody cares. I promise nobody gives a shit what you do with your life, man. No one cares. The only reason we care is because you constantly feel the need to fucking shove it down our throat. No one cares. You know, the bisexual shit, you know, I'm not so sure that they're bisexual. I think a lot of them are just fucking them freaks that want to fuck a lot, you know, on both sides. I don't understand. You got people, fucking JoJo, the little weird girl with the fucking stupid ponytail. Like, everybody, since she turns 18, it's like, you know, because the sick fucking world we live in and the sick Hollywood shit that she lives in, seems like everybody, as soon as she turned 18, they want to know about her sexuality. And I'm like, who gives a shit? She's still a little kid to me. She's still got the stupid fucking bow in her hair. But her ridiculous answer was that, well, the first part was ridiculous, that she is, was it pansexual or some shit? Pot sexual, fucking plate sexual, whatever it is. Fucking dishwasher non-sexuality and some shit. And then the second part of the question made more sense. Like, I'm still a kid. I haven't even really even thought about it yet. Which at 18, you should probably know whether you're gay or not, I suppose. But, you know, this girl grew up in Hollywood, so there's no telling what the fuck she's had to damn deal with sexually. So that's disgusting. That's another topic. But anyway, holla, we don't care if you're gay. Suck dick all you want. That's your problem. You know, no need to put it in every single sitcom, I guess. Peace.
Nice. Listen, 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 yo. Wow. So, okay, just so people understand that that may have sounded way off track, but the thing is that, like, I don't know. It sounds like I got some kind of problem.
I got what you're saying, though, because, you know, art is supposed to mimic life. And when you show your depiction of life as being, you know, full of this or full of that, when that's not really what's going on, you know, you can tell that the only reason it's being done is because somebody wants to prove a point of we're down with the alphabet people. And that's fine. You can be down with them, but you don't have to make everything.
I'm down with them. Do what the fuck you want.
Yeah. You know what? The only people that you can possibly say might not like you are religious folks that go by the Bible where it says, you know, thou shalt not whatever. But even them, they don't even hate you because they know that they're not supposed to. They actually wish the best fucking blessings for you, and that they see. They don't agree with the way you live, but they still wish God's blessings upon you. They don't hate you. You know, so all the people that are, you know, oh, the Christians are just fucking, you know, anti this and anti that. No.
Well, look, I mean, it's just like every single other isms, this kind of goes back to the first part. Yes, there's people that do hate you. I mean, there's people that hate everything. I mean, you know.
Yeah, but how many can you possibly say?
Right.
How many, you know, there's such a minute fucking number.
Right. I'm saying, like, the problem is, like I said, nobody's walking around constantly goddamn talking shit about gay people. Like, I don't see it anywhere ever. So I'm just saying that, like, the only time it comes up is when they say it. You know what I'm saying? The only time I see anybody talking junk about black people is when it's on TV and some black person is saying that some white person did. You know what I'm saying? Like, I never seen it. I don't see it. I ain't saying never seen it. I don't see it. It's not a regular occurrence. The same with the gay shit. I don't know anybody that still talks shit about gay people. I mean, like, back in the day, people are, you fucking fag. But it's just because we don't fucking know no better. We were fucking teenagers or something, or it was back then, and it was just like, you know.
And to us, when we use that terminology, you fucking fag, it wasn't even like we're literally putting down gay people. Anything, like, for example, you know, you look at something and say, I'm
just so down our gay friends by suggesting they're gay.
Dude, that's so gay. Like, you see your buddy walking in, you know, with some fucking, you know, pink Reeboks or some shit. You know, dude, that's hella gay.
You know,
does that mean it's bad? I mean, he's gonna get defensive about it because he's like, man, I'm not fucking gay. But I mean, in all, is it really fucking bad? Yeah, so fucking what?
Bottom line, it's the same with the autism. Like, who the fuck, you know, and I shouldn't say it's the same because I know there's a lot more, people are a lot more serious about gay people than they are about deaf people, of course. But
right,
like,
right.
So don't get me wrong there. I'm just saying that I just don't think that it's so bad that you got to constantly tell us about how shitty it is to be gay. Well, apparently it's great because everybody seems to love y'all. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people hate me. So, and they're perfectly okay. Nobody's going to have a problem with it. You can never just go in there and go, man, this motherfucker gay dude was making fun of me because I was straight. That's like going to court and being like, my wife beat me up. You're like, pussy. You know what I'm saying? Or, man, she won't stop harassing me. This woman keeps grabbing my dick. And they're like, oh, geez, man, play the fucking violin for this poor bastard. I'm married and my dick ain't been touched in 17 weeks, motherfucker.
Nah, it comes to, like I said earlier, it comes down to the fucking, you know, if art mimicking life, you know, with the movie thing, and then, you know, with when it comes to people making these claims about, you know, bigotry and prejudice and whatnot, you be real about it. Keep it on a realistic plane. Don't exaggerate shit. Don't overplay things, you know. Just if somebody, you know, says something, don't turn that into, oh, everybody in my neighborhood hates me now. No, that one motherfucker said something stupid. Don't you know, blow things out of proportion.
People, I mean, it's always, I guess that type of shit's gonna always exist, but like the only people I see mentioning gay hate are gay people. Period.
99.9%, yeah.
That's what I'm trying to say. And I mean, that if anybody takes that wrong, then fuck you. I don't know what to tell you. That shit's plain and simple is that I don't see nobody talking about it but gay people. And, you know, so.
One more thing to throw in here. You know, when it comes to debating transsexuality or pansexuality or the significance of genders or the meaning of genders in society, the roles they play and whatnot. When you start getting into debates like that and the truth is spoken, like logically, like, you know, male, female, other, and, you know, male can only be male, female can only be female, you know, but if you switch, you know, we start getting into all the technical crap about that. People, all that pertains to seem to get offended by it because, like, for example, when you start talking about the pronouns and whatnot, and, you know, somebody has a particular pronoun, if somebody that they don't know doesn't refer to them as their specific pronoun, they get offended. Well, it's just like talking to a woman who won't tell you what the fuck she actually wants or what she's actually thinking. Are you supposed to be fucking psychic? You know, I don't know your fucking pronouns. I don't know what the fuck you.
That's why you don't say any of them stupid fucking pronouns. Yeah, again, you know, God bless the South. I love the fucking place that I live because it's some more shit you'll never see. What you do see everywhere you go is yes, ma'am, yes, sir. Hell yeah, buddy. Look here, sweetie. Yeah. Hey, darling, can you do this for me, baby? Nobody gives a fuck.
Right, but imagine, you know, the hey, darling, hey, sweetie, whatever, and it happens to be, you know, somebody that identifies as a dude, and that they're, okay, you can only go on what you perceive them as, and you're not trying to, you know, disrespect anybody. You're not trying to be rude to them. You're actually trying to be courteous.
That's my problem is I am trying. Like, once they start talking shit to me, then I do, because I'll be like, fuck you, you're a fucking
man. I'm talking initially. Yeah. Like, when you first greet them, your perception of this person initially is female. That's what they look like. That's what you're going to dress them as because you're trying to be respectful. Yes, ma'am. Yes, whatever. And if they get mad at you at that point, then that's when it becomes their fucking problem because they do not have the fucking right to expect you to know that they're not a fucking female.
If she was like, assume I'm a female, I'd be like, you're a female. Like, fuck you. I don't give a shit. I'll start talking shit then because I'll be like, I'm not doing anything to purposely hurt you. I can't believe you're so fucking ridiculous. If you're over 25 and you're acting like that, you're a fucking idiot.
A rational person would say, "Hey, just a heads up, I'm a dude. So if you wouldn't mind referring to me as a dude, I'd appreciate it." And you know what? Even if he's standing there in a fucking skirt with makeup on, and he says, "You know, just call me my pronouns are he and him." Whatever, dude. Okay, fine. He just told me his pronouns. You know, so
this is my first time somebody called me and told me their pronouns.
You know, and if that's the case, and he approaches with respect and a rational mindset, then I'm going to be like, okay, fine, yeah, sure, whatever, because I'm not trying to be an asshole. I'm not trying to disrespect you. You know, but up until that point, if I don't know, don't expect me to fucking miraculously happen.
I don't see any of that stuff, man. It's never like that around here, man. I know up north and maybe out that way too. It's rampant. I know it's happening, but like, man,
I haven't even seen it around here. But just the fact that I know it, there are places that where it is happening.
People definitely exist all the way up into their 40s, and it's like. I mean, I understand why an 8-year-old would act this ridiculous, but you're like, you come in there with fucking high heels, mini skirt, long blonde hair, makeup on your face, big tits, booty and shit, you know what I'm saying? Fingernails done up, and I'm like, hey, excuse me, miss. Excuse me. The name's Dave.
Right.
Fuck you, motherfucker. You clearly wanted to be a bitch this morning.
Right.
And you're being a bitch even as a man. Either way, Dave.
Right. Oh my God! But look, folks. The bottom line of all this is that, you know, a lot of this shit is taken out of proportion. It's taken out of context, and it's misunderstood. The people reacting to you are just as misunderstood as you are to them. So there has to be some sort of rational fucking, you know, interaction where you can say, "Hey, look. You know, I'm not this, I'm not that, I am this, please refer to me as that." People will respect that. people will respect that if you if you're respectful. That's all it takes. It's all.
I'll be honest. I may not respect that. Look, if Bruce Jenner ever, if I ever had to meet somebody like that, I'd be like, I mean, now, here's the thing. If somebody walked up and said, "This is Caitlyn," like, let's say he's not a fucking star or whatever, and they were like, "This is Caitlyn," I'd be like, "What's up, man?" Like, I mean, or whatever. I don't even know what I would say. But it would be hard for me to sit there and pretend that this dude would have fucking goddamn 5 o'clock shadow. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't want to play them games.
No,
and again, I'm just blessed and happy and lucky to be in a place where I swear to God, I don't know. I've seen them. Don't get me wrong. They're all over the place. There's people walking around with fucking, you know, all kind of shit happens over here. Nobody gives a fuck. Nobody fucks with them. Nobody supports them. Nobody don't support them. Nobody gives a fuck. They just do their thing. He's clearly fucking weird. I don't know what the fuck he's doing. He's got fucking like high heel shoes, but he's wearing fucking baggy jeans. And it's crazy, but he is doing it. And I don't give a shit. We're going to talk shit about him in private.
Oh, my God.
That's it, man. Nobody's like, you fucking get out of our mall, you weirdo. Like, none of that shit. Out there, I mean, it just depends on what side you're on out in other places, too. I mean, you can dress any way you want, unless it ain't them. I don't know. You can just do whatever you want. That's my bottom line. Do what the fuck you want, man. Leave me out of it. That's all I'm saying. I'm not super traditional, but I do like to keep, you know, I just don't want any kind of any futuristic shit from my anything that involves my kids' grown up life. Ain't none of your motherfucking business. All I'm saying. Anything that is not pertaining to what you teach in school, shut the fuck up about it. If you damn are a fucking gym teacher, then I don't give a rat's ass what your fucking damn favorite anything is except sports team. Maybe that. And even still, don't try to make my kids like the Dallas Cowboys or some bullshit.
And my kids better not know what the fuck your sexual preference is, what your political fucking, you know, political views are. They better not fucking know what religion you are. That they shouldn't know that, and leave it all out. Leave it all out. Stick to the reading, writing, and arithmetic shit. Stick to that.
Teaching truly does start in the house.
Yeah. Yeah. Anyways, folks. So I think
manufacturing company.
I believe we've wound down here. So is there any? Do you have any last words, Mr. Brooks?
Goodbye. They love me.
Adios, motherfuckers. Adios, motherfuckers.
All right, y'all. Holla at you motherfucking peoples.
Deuces.